A keto or ketogenic diet is a popular way for people to lose weight. The diet focuses on a high intake of healthy fat and protein, while limiting the intake of carbohydrates to less than 50 grams per day. On a diabetic-friendly diet, someone usually consumes up to 200 to 225 grams of carbs per day, along with a balanced amount of fat and protein. Carbs are often the bad guy when it comes to insulin resistance and high blood glucose. So, it is easy to assume that significantly reducing your carbohydrate intake could help your diabetes. However, is that really the case? Don't go anywhere and keep watching. In this video, we'll explore how keto can influence your diabetes. We'll also look at the potential side effects that can come with a keto diet and answer the ultimate question: can keto reverse diabetes? But before we dive in, can you do us a favor and like this video, ring the bell for future notifications, and make sure to subscribe to the Diabetics Talk channel for more help managing diabetes. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get 2 free gifts. And now, let's get started by exploring what is keto and how it influences diabetes. Keto is a low-carbohydrate and high-fat diet. In keto, fat primarily refers to unsaturated or healthy fat, and usually includes nuts and seeds, avocado, fatty fish, olive, coconut, and other plant oil. Keto also requires a good amount of protein, usually from lean or fatty sources of meat. The carbohydrate count is restricted, and that includes complex carbs. Carbohydrates are used by the body as a primary source of energy, and that's because carbs are often rich in minerals, vitamins, and fiber. With diabetes, it is recommended to consume complex carbs, such as beans, whole grains, starchy vegetables, and fruits, to ensure the body maintains a nutritional balance. So, what happens to the body on a ketogenic diet? Well, when you start keto, your body quickly runs out of glucose to burn after a few days. And as a result, it taps into stored fat for energy by activating a cellular process called nutritional ketosis. During ketosis, the body starts producing blood acids called ketones. If you have insulin resistance, ketones make it so that your body needs to make and use less insulin. And when ketosis is paired with somewhat controlled blood glucose levels, it can lead to weight loss benefits for people with type 2 diabetes. In a study on 84 people with obesity or type 2 diabetes, researchers required volunteers to follow either a reduced calorie diet involving less than 500 grams of carbs per day, or a keto diet involving less than 20 grams of carbs per day. After 24 weeks, they observed that those who consumed the keto diet experienced an improvement in glycemic control and reduced their insulin medication. Another study also pointed out a ketogenic diet could increase weight loss, blood glucose balance, and A1C levels in people with type 2 diabetes. These research suggests that a ketogenic diet may be beneficial for diabetics. Not only can it improve important markers linked to diabetes, but also reduce to some level the dependence on medication. That said, not everyone can have success with keto. The diet is quite restrictive and can be difficult to maintain in the long term. Additionally, if you're living with type 1 diabetes, diabetes mellitus, or simply struggle to maintain your blood glucose levels in a healthy range on a daily basis, a keto diet can come with important side effects. But before we dive into those, are you ready for a free gift? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free one-hour documentary, The Scary Truth About Sugar. Both gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. And now let's look at the side effects of a keto diet for diabetics. If you struggle to control your diabetes, a ketogenic diet might not be the best choice for you. And one of the main reasons is because a keto diet can lead to diabetic ketoacidosis. Diabetic ketoacidosis is a complication that occurs when the body produces too many ketones or acid in the blood and not enough insulin. And yes, we've seen that ketones can help with insulin resistance. However, the body still needs enough insulin to maintain a healthy metabolism. Without it, ketones can build up in the blood very quickly and lead to symptoms such as excessive thirst, frequent urination, nausea and vomiting, stomach pain, and fatigue and headaches. Diabetic ketoacidosis is more prevalent in people with type 1 diabetes, when the body can't produce insulin on its own. When following a ketogenic diet as a diabetic, it is important to monitor blood glucose levels. The American Diabetes Association points out that if their level is 240 milligrams per deciliter, testing ketones levels with a urine strip is recommended. Another side effect to watch out for on a keto diet is signs of heart disease. Since a keto diet primarily focuses on fat, there are risks for it to increase your levels of blood pressure, triglycerides, and LDL cholesterol, which are the main markers for heart diseases. Research points out that a ketogenic diet has the capacity to increase blood lipids and risks of heart disease. Additionally, experts note that limiting various foods, such as fruit, starchy vegetables, and complex carbs, can reduce the nutritional variety in your diet, and therefore lead to nutrient deficiencies. Many studies have observed that mineral and vitamin deficiency in diabetes can increase blood glucose imbalances, insulin resistance, and risks of diabetes mellitus. Overall, a ketogenic diet can increase the risks of diabetic ketoacidosis, heart disease, and nutrient deficiency. So ultimately, can it reverse diabetes? The short answer is no. A keto diet may help improve certain symptoms linked to diabetes, but the potential side effects are important, especially if you struggle to control your diabetes. So if you were thinking of starting a keto diet, make sure to speak with your doctor or a dietitian, as they will be able to help you get started in a safe and controlled way. And there you have it. And now we want to hear from you. Are you considering starting a keto diet? Share your thoughts in the comment section below. And before you leave, make sure to claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell button for more Diabetics Talk. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.